Hey, Nice Guy community, as you well know or may not know, we run on listener donations exclusively. So we really need you to go to patreon.com/niceguys and just donate like a buck or two a month.
How would they not know that already? It seems like it would be impossible. We talk about this ad nauseum. patreon.com/niceguys. Help us, please.
Well, maybe they're a new listener. We do get those occasionally.
Well, that's true. Occasionally. We lose a lot, but we gain a lot too.
For as little as a dollar or two a month, you can help keep the lights on. Thanks. We love you guys.
Hey, I was just thinking, maybe this show we do something different. Maybe it, you know, not suck.
There's so many things I let go. You know, there's so many things I let go in my life like that. That's just one that
like
I
like what? Really... Just give me one that you do let go, because I don't think there really are that many that, you know, you let go.
And now, broadcasting from the hatchback of a 72 Ford Pinto, it's the Nice Guys on Business podcast. Need an education on how to grow your business? The Nice Guys are here to help. Learn about great customer service, networking, and how just being nice can help you prosper. Now, here are your hosts, Doug Sandler and Strickland Bonner.
So I was watching. Hey, did we start the episode?
I don't know. Have we? I thought this is this bonus material. We have special guest Mar on today. Welcome back. Welcome back. Funkin' fans, my name is Strickland Bonner. On the other side of the microphone, Mr. Doug Sandler. And on the third side of the microphone, we have Mar.
Mar.
Hello.
Hey.
Are there limited numbers of sides of the microphone?
No, unlimited sides to the microphone.
So I'm watching a clip. My brother says, oh, you're going to love this. He shows me a clip of the Howard Stern movie, what is it, Private Parts, many, many years ago.
I don't think this is one of the topics, but I'm going to give you a free
on,
one.
Come on, just give me a pass. Why do you take all the spontaneity out of what I want to do? You're always doing this to me, Strickland.
I know, I'm terrible. Go ahead.
This was the reason why I had to get a divorce. You realize
this,
right?
Here's your freebie. It's okay. It's okay, Doug. How long were you married, though? You were married like 22 years, right?
Almost 20 years. I think it was almost 20 years.
Almost 20 years? We got a good 17 years left before we have to break up.
Strick, you and I have actually known each other almost or maybe longer than...
not longer than you've been married, than you were married.
Yeah, Strick, when did we meet? We met in like 19... I think.
When did you start with the agency? Yeah, that's about right.
So what is that, 2000?
I'm going to beep those years out so you people won't know how old we are. Doug and I have known each other a very long time.
Okay, we've known each other. God, you are so sensitive when it comes to that stuff. I thought I was sensitive. Now you're like ultra sensitive and you're just a pain in the ass about it.
Exactly, yep.
Anyway, so my brother was showing me this clip from the Howard Stern movie. You know, when he was on the air with NBC, or I think it was NBC. It wasn't CBS. I think it was NBC. When he was on the air with them, Mar is now sending me text messages. She's... Mar, you're on the air with us, aren't you?
Yeah, Mar, why did you mute yourself? Like, is she sending you text messages to your phone as well as to the Zencaster?
Yeah, Mar, because you can't put a picture through Zencaster. Look at this setup she has. Holy shit.
You gotta send it to me.
She's
Mar,
legit.
And just unmute yourself. Come on, we want you on the show. We want you to talk today.
Yeah.
Oh, here, you sent me one too. Okay, never mind. I'm sorry.
Okay. Totally. Anyway, so my brother sends me a clip from the Howard Stern movie Private Parts, and he talks about the words that you can't say, like you can't say cock and you can't say pussy and you can't
say the seven words you can't say on television.
So he sets up this play game, like almost like the Match Game with the theme running in the background. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm about to say blank a doodle do.
Nice.
Okay, keep the music going, and the other one is... All right, I'm about to say a word. Blank willow. and all right, Jackie the Joke Man Martling like chimes in with... Well, let's see. It's not as big as I thought it was, but cock-a-doodle-doo. It was just a total shit show. I don't even remember why I brought up that point. Normally what happens is I start a topic and then you have me so sidetracked I don't even remember why I even talk about the topic anymore.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll stop then. I'm sorry.
Fine,
I'm just, you know,
fine.
Trying to enter some entertainment into
All right, let's,
it.
Well, as a matter of fact, speaking of entertainment, Strickland, we have a new promise statement. Do you know the promise statement, the new one?
Yeah, go ahead. Why don't you do it?
To provide an experience that is entertaining and adds value to your life.
Has Mar chimed in yet to say whether she wants to keep that or tweak it or change it?
I wish, Mar, would you just open up your microphone and chat with us so you're not texting us? Can you do that?
okay, you guys did fine. It sounds good.
What's that?
The promise statement? You don't want to change it?
No, you play with that.
This is your opportunity to really mold the show. You're not going to run with it?
I'll think about it.
Mara is like kind of like the executive producer. She's like the one that's sitting in the booth that is listening to everything that's going on and making sure that we're heading down the right path. And when we just need her, she just opens up her mic and she starts talking. Mara, this is an opportunity for you to really mold the show. And if you feel like we're not going down the right path or the right avenue, right now is really a good time for us to chat about this.
I know, but I need to go into my cave and think about it first.
Oh,
that's fine then. That's okay. You're allowed to do that.
Oh, I didn't know the process of Amar. I'm sorry. I did not know the process that Mar goes through for when you go into the cave, is Prash in the cave?
Nobody's allowed in there.
Wow.
Ooh,
nobody's
allowed in the cave.
Interesting. Nobody's allowed in Mar's cave. Now, we could take that in one of many ways.
Oh, my God. Okay, I'm jumping off.
On that note.
Here's what happens in Mar's cave.
Mar does not like the spotlight put on her. I found that she's a really... Oh, it's the match game. Okay, you have reached the match game.
That's
now,
the match game think music. That's what happens when Mar goes into her cave.
My name is Gene Rayburn. Here we go. Starting with round one of the match game.
And if you're not familiar with... Right, if you're not familiar with how the show works, right?
Yeah,
it's,
yeah.
Okay... Celebrities, now try to find an answer to this. Blank a doodle doo. And then the music starts, and of course they're panning across all the celebrities as they're thinking about the music.
With the long skinny microphone.
Right. It's a great mic.
Yeah, that's the funniest. That's a great game show. All right, Strick, I think we are already probably 10 minutes into the episode, almost 7.5 minutes in, and we have not yet even spun the topic wheel once. So should we get to the topics?
Let's see what our topics are. Left over from probably last Thursday.
Yes.
Spicer. Sean Spicer. I don't know if this is still news anymore. I mean, who knows who the hell we've bombed.
Holy
now,
shit.
Like a week and a half later.
Talk about a total fuck up. This guy, he's the press secretary, right?
Yep.
Okay, so he's the guy that, he's like the mouthpiece for the presidency.
Yep.
Talk about a
words,
total fuckwad. Okay, so not only does he not have the facts straight. Now, I understand if he was like a host of a show like the Nice Guys on Business podcast, every once in a while getting the facts out of order, or even 90% of the time, like we do fucking up things. Dude. It's not a fucking Holocaust center, okay? As a Jewish guy, not even as a, like a really Orthodox, not even necessary. I'm like Jew-ish, heavy on the ish. Don't fucking call it. How do you possibly corporatize a fucking death camp by calling it a Holocaust center? What the fuck did you mean by that exactly is what I want to know.
You know, I'm just waiting for like a press conference, right? Where Sean Spicer does something like that. Like he mentions Holocaust centers and he keeps talking, right? And somebody walks up to him and whispers something in his ear. And then he goes, oh, I'm sorry. I meant the concentration camps. But, you know, at least he didn't use chemical weapons against these people the Syrians have. Wait a minute. Hold on.
Okay,
somebody
okay.
whispers in his ear. Gassing is a fucking chemical weapon. Are you a fucking idiot? Like, come on.
All right,
Sean, are you kidding me?
So let's continue this. Let's continue it. All right. So so he says Holocaust Center.
Right.
And then the guy walks up to him and says, go ahead, do it again.
Okay, Mr. Spicer, it was a concentration camp.
I'm so sorry. I meant the concentration camps and, of course, the death camps that Hitler used. But what I meant to say was at least the country of their origin did not use chemical weaponry like sarin gas against the residents and the citizens of...
Mr. Spicer.
Yes.
The Jews that were in the concentration camps, they were German.
What do you mean they were German?
They were German. So the
no,
6 million
no, 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 no.
Jews.
Hold on a second. Hold on. I'm gonna stand by this. They weren't. They were Jewish. They weren't Germans.
Mr. Spicer?
Yes.
Judaism is a religion.
Yeah.
It doesn't say where they're from.
You've got to be fucking kidding me. Who's giving me this information?
Two different things. Yeah.
Yeah. Are you sure? 100%.
I'm pretty sure. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to call an audible on this one. Let's go back to Holocaust Center for a moment.
I don't think that's a good idea, Mr. Spicer. I don't think that's a good idea.
Give me some advice. What should I do now?
Leave immediately.
Yeah. So at what point do they say, dude, you're fucking out of a job?
I know. It's so ridiculous.
The whole, the bastardizing of the entire subject. If you're a guy that's running the Nice Guys on Business podcast, I'm going to say that you probably, I'm going to give you a pass. You're allowed to fuck it up a few times. All right.
Yeah. Eat, sleep, drink, Dubai. You can, reach out to us and bitch, but we're still going to keep doing our same fuckery and probably mess up some facts here and there.
Okay. So, right. Exactly.
Oh, we still have not heard back from him. I wonder if he really is working with the president. That'd be pretty cool.
Fuck. He's not working for the president. I doubt it's even a real person. It probably is like some bot
probably
that
we've
been
communicating
with. So then I'm like going through a whole bunch of the news accounts of everything, and I'm watching. Oh, sorry, this is another topic. Maybe I should just not go on to the next topic. Did we finish with Spicer? Because
No, it's okay. You can go on to the next topic. I don't really want to talk about Spicer much more because this is like timely stuff because this is going to air a week and a half later, and who knows how many more bombs we will have dropped by then.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, speaking of bombs, so we dropped this bomb on this remote part of Afghanistan, the mother of all bombs, it's called, okay, the MOAB.
Mm-hmm.
And as we're dropping the bombs and we're accounting for this, so CNN is getting on and they're explaining it, and NBC and CBS are explaining it in terms that I would consider it would be an appropriate way to document what has been going on.
Doug.
Yeah.
Fake news. It's all fake news.
Wait, all of that stuff is fake news?
Fake news. It's all fake news.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry.
So,
no, go ahead. If you're saying good things about me, like how I'm dropping bombs and killing the bad guys, that's okay. That's not fake news.
In other words, what you're telling me is when Fox is playing like this, almost like thank God to live in the USA, like bombs dropping on America, bombs dropping on this theme music as they come in the intro, and they're showing a video of this 20 seconds that it took for this mother of all bombs to drop.
Mm-hmm.
They're commercializing the dropping of this bomb. There's a theme music to the dropping of the bomb.
Is it this?
What is that?
Wait a minute.
That's not it. No.
Hey, here's an actual video of the B-17 bomber that was flying over Afghanistan. And that's right, here is what it looks like when the bomb goes down. And that's right, you baby dropped a bomb on me.
No. I holy shit.
Yeah.
All right, man,
look at that smoke go up. Here we go, baby. That's right. Okay,
okay, that's a copyright violation.
Thank you, Mar.
Oh,
Mar,
yeah,
is our legal
true.
Department.
Yeah,
now.
That is true. I didn't think about that. We are now not allowed to post that up on YouTube.
On YouTube,
you
because
that,
we get
right?
so many listens on YouTube. Yeah,
that's true. So the Fox hosts, they're coming in and they're playing a video of the actual event where they're showing the mother of all bombs being mm-hmm. the MOAB being dropped. The Fox host is saying dropping. Okay, as it's coming down, what freedom looks like? That's the red, white, and blue.
Wait, but this is on Fox, right?
Yeah, it's Geraldo.
Well, that's
Geraldo
why.
Says,
okay, Fox and flying the flag, rah-rah, okay.
Geraldo, and I think this is a quote from Geraldo, it's one of my favorite things to watch. I'm like, dude, there's fucking people that are dying in that. Now, granted, these guys are terrorists, and they should not be alive. But on the other side of it, too, how about if we not so much, what's the word I'm searching for, Strick?
Sensationalize?
Thank you. Let's not sensationalize the cost of life that war takes, because all this is doing is it's fucking stirring the pot.
But Doug, these are a few of my favorite things. No, I couldn't agree with you more. It's ridiculous.
Dumbest
it's like
thing.
Trump's like, oh yeah, we're just going to defeat ISIS, right? We're where the fuck are they? Yes, it's very easy to pick a really remote portion of Afghanistan that has tunnels, nothing else around it. No cities, no civilians, no chance of anybody getting hurt because it's in the middle of nowhere and you just happen to know that there's some tunnels there. Hey, let's bomb the tunnels. Here's the other thing. Like they said, 34 ISIS militants were killed. How do they know that?
I don't know.
Did they send guys down afterwards and count the bodies? I mean, they're in the middle of nowhere. I understand when you're in like a firefight, maybe you can figure out how many people got killed. But when you drop the mother of all bombs, how do you know that 34 people were in the tunnels underground? And come on, it's ridiculous. But it's not so easy to, like, when ISIS is using cities and children and hospitals as human shields to just go in and, well, let's just kill them all. We'll just bomb them all. It doesn't work that way. It's not that easy.
I just don't like how, and you hit the exact word that I was looking for. Thank you. And it was escaping me, sensationalized. It's just like, fuck, can we just, let's get done with this. Let's just move on. All of this fucking killing is just the most ridiculous thing ever on both sides. People, we are human beings. Can we all just get along, please?
Yep. Yep, I agree. Are we getting a little too serious here? Do we need to pick a new topic?
Yeah. Sorry, that one just, I was scouring the news looking for some good topics to talk about, I came across that one and it just really, again, it's just one of those things I don't like. All right, let's spin the, let's get off of that topic. Thank you. Oh, I know which one I'm hoping it is. Please, 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 please.
Which one
please
are you hoping it is, Doug?
Well, I'll wait for you to tell me which one it landed on since I can't actually see the wheel from here.
Man code bathroom etiquette?
Okay.
Is that not the one you were hoping?
No,
it would be?
Let's talk about totally going from one extreme to the other. So,
exactly. Well, you can pick one. You get one freebie each week.
I'm gonna go with this one because I feel like I'm just gonna dig into it. Do we have time? How much time? Where are
we?
We're good on time. Yeah, we're good. We're good. So I'm at, as you know, I am at Victoria's Gastro Pub, and we are enjoying
not Victoria's
ourselves.
Secret.
No, definitely not Victoria's Secret. We call this place Vix. Nice guy community, just so you're aware. And since Strick has not come up with the exposition music yet, I will continue to tell. Damn you, Strickland Bonner. You were waiting. Wait, was that...
Yes, I was.
That wasn't Barney. What was that?
Rockford Files.
I was going to say, what the fuck was that music? That was the theme song. Yeah, you got it. Nice.
You know who wrote that music?
I was gonna go Barry Manilow. Wait. All right, sure.
The only problem with that music?
It's too loud.
Well, okay, I can turn it down too. But the fact that we both know it is kind of a clue as to how fucking old we are too.
No,
hey, Mar, you have no goddamn idea what the hell that was, right? I guarantee you, Mar was
no
like.
No clue.
What the hell was it? What is the Rockford Files? Like, you don't even know what it is, do you?
Strickland, I'm going to go for...
Hang on, Mar, do you even know what the Rockford Files is?
No.
You know what Gilligan's Island is, right? I mean, I know that was like in the 60s, but it's... Right, exactly. It's on repeats for... And MASH, right? Like, you know MASH. But Rockford Files, you don't fucking know, do you?
Strickland, I'm going to go with what is obscure detective shows from the 1970s for 100
points? It wasn't that obscure, but it is like... Let's say it didn't have legs. It did, like, A-Team. Mar, you know what the A-Team is, right?
You're so wrong about it. It had legs. It wasn't... Was Rockford Files... It was prime time at one point, wasn't it?
Oh, of course, yeah. But, I mean, there's certain shows that, you know... Okay, so it's like a song, right? You get a hit song, and maybe it's, like, monstrously huge at the time, but a year later, nobody cares what it is. But there are other ones that hold on. Like Crazy in Love is a great example, right?
Crazy in Love is a great song
that everybody knows. And 10 years later, you still will listen to it because it's a great song, right? But Toxic from Britney Spears, like it was huge when it first came out, but nobody's going to play that on the radio anymore.
No,
right?
Totally right.
That's how I see Rockford Files. Rockford Files was really big in the 70s, but it wasn't like Brady Bunch big or Gillian's Island big, where you're going to see it in reruns for years and years.
Let's keep it in its genre. So it was no Barnaby Jones big, is what you're saying.
You're back to the fucking 50s and it shit was or no, something. Now. I don't even know Barnaby Jones.
It was no Marcus Welby big, is what you mean to say.
Oh my God, Doug. You're way fucking back. Like, I don't even know that shit. That's like the 60s.
You're saying it was no Mannix big. Is that what you're telling me? Exactly, Strickland?
McMillan and wife, right?
McMillan and wife. It was no, shit. What was the name of that show where Jack Klugman starred as a guy?
Oh, Quincy.
Quincy is one, but he starred in another one where he actually played a forensic guy. Do you remember that one?
Quincy?
Oh, was that Quincy?
Yeah, I think
so,
right?
Oh, that was Quincy. Okay, you could be right.
Because it was like he worked in the morgue, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gosh. Cool, all the great. I sat in front of the television set. I used to come home from school. If I was lucky, I did my homework. Very rarely did I do my homework, which is obviously why I'm a podcast host now. And I would get right to television. As soon as dinner was over, TV was on, and I didn't stop watching television until probably 12 or 12:30.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, it was a good seven-hour stretch.
Mar, what shows do you watch right now? What's big right now?
I don't watch TV.
Yeah, Mar. At all? You don't watch TV? I love that.
That's good.
Not really.
Like, not even Netflix or anything?
Netflix sometimes, but I'm very behind on that.
Thanks, Mar. Thanks, Mar. Thank you. And that was Mar. Hey, Strickland's probably trying to download something from Netflix. Strick, what are you doing?
Apparently something is like it's possible that my car alarm is going off. I have no idea why.
Oh, you want to pause for a second?
No, I just handed the keys to my daughter. Oh. It was like, I don't know what the hell's
what
going
happened?
On. I'm sorry, Mar. So what do you watch?
She doesn't watch anything. She doesn't watch television.
I'm very behind on Netflix. I'm very behind.
That's okay.
I like to watch.
How's the job going, by the way? Are you still working for the guy that hasn't actually hired you for a real job, but it's like kind of a real job? Great work today. I'll most likely kill you in the morning.
Basically.
wait, I missed that. What is that? What was that comment, Strickland?
That's from the Princess Bride. Thank you, Mar.
Oh, what was the? Oh,
I love all your references.
Thank you, Mar. I appreciate it.
I forgot to tell you, Strickland, because of you, I watched The Princess Bride also, and I do know.
Oh
that
my God, you had never seen The Princess Bride?
No, there were three. Fight Club. There was a number of Strick. You know, I'd have no life, and you know that. You know
Princess
that about
Bride
me
is kind of amazing.
It's a classic. It really you have is. To see that. Oh my God.
I don't know. My wife really hit me one day with, oh, you've got to watch Clue because Clue is the best movie ever. I'm like,
what?
I watch it. I'm like, that is fucking not the best movie ever. I know,
not even close.
I know. I didn't like it. I didn't like it at all.
You have to watch Deadpool tonight.
So we're hanging out in, I wrote it down. I will definitely watch Deadbolt tonight. So
Deadpool, not Deadbolt.
Deadpool.
It was only the biggest movie of 2016. You know, Ryan Reynolds, the biggest star in the world. I don't know who the hell he is.
Did it win an award?
I don't know.
Strickland, did it win an award?
It actually was nominated, I think, for an Oscar. I think the screenplay was nominated.
Okay, if it got nominated, then I will put it into the one of the biggest categories. Then that's fine.
Yeah, because all of those Oscar-winning movies are so great, right? Like you've seen La La Land, and you've seen it's all the.
I could not tell you which movies won an Oscar and which didn't. I don't even give a shit about that. Some of the worst movies are some of the worst movies out there are the best movies that I've enjoyed watching, and I'm like, why didn't this win anything?
Yeah, Deadpool is ridiculously funny. Okay. It's so good.
Well, I'm gonna watch it. I'm gonna watch it. Let me get back to the topic in hand. So the reason I have the category of what was it, man? What's the category topic?
I gotta get back to it. Hold on. Whoop. Wait a minute. Man code bathroom etiquette.
All right. So you're in the bathroom. There's a few things that happen in men's bathrooms. Let me just
explain. The public bathroom, at your house.
No, public bathroom, exactly. So the number one faux pas, the thing that will really just completely just grates on my nerves and just refuse to be able to understand is somebody actually leaving a public restroom without washing their hands. That fucking, that kills me. That kills me. Okay, so when you go into the men's room at a public place, the stand-up urinals and then the sit-down toilets. You know, obviously the sit-down toilets are all, the toilets are all in little, whatever, toilet booths. What do you call those stalls? Sometimes there is a divider between the urinals in the bathroom.
Right.
Okay. Do you, man code, do you, let's say there's five urinals.
Right.
Okay. One guy tees up in the urinal number one.
Mm-hmm.
Where do you go if you go in there?
Anywhere but urinal number two.
Anywhere but urinal number two.
Right, exactly. Unless you absolutely have to, you don't stand to the one right. next so to it. And man no texting code, from the bathroom.
Right, so right. So man code is that you do not tee up at urinal number two if this guy's in urinal number one. So let me clarify. Guy comes in, walks into urinal number two. There are five there. What is your choice?
So 3, 4, and 5 are open? Is that what you're saying?
1, 3, 4, and 5 are open.
So you choose 4 or 5.
4 or 5, or go to the one of the stalls, correct?
Sure, yeah.
Okay, great. So that to me is just man code. Hang on. Yeah,
so okay. Let's say hypothetically, there's somebody at 1 and there's somebody at 3.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So the choice is either stand next to an occupied urinal or use the stall.
You got to go. Well, there's 5 urinals, so you can go to 5 because right. 5
okay,
is
I
not
Okay, I wasn't sure because I wouldn't do that. Like, I wouldn't go sit down at a stall just because I had to stand next to somebody.
No, okay. I agree
wouldn't
with that.
Do that.
Yeah,
no,
I
like,
agree. I agree with that. I agree. I had to think about that for a second, but no, I agree. I agree with that. So somebody
is finding this fascinating. I'm
so
sure.
So somebody is in. All right. So now you walk into a crowded restroom. There's 5 stalls. Same 5 stalls. 1, 3, and 5 are occupied because right. everybody has followed man code.
Mm-hmm,
so,
of course.
So far, which is appropriate. So do you choose 2, 4, or 1 of the stalls? So I'm okay, as I think you are okay also. 2 or 4 is now fair game, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. All right, great. I'm just making sure. All right. So next thing is 1, 3, forget where people are situated in there. You're in the bathroom. There's one other guy in there. He's at whatever stall. You're at what other stall. And as he is relieving himself, he lets go of a huge fart.
Okay.
Okay, do you find that acceptable or not acceptable in your world?
Yeah, it's a bathroom. You got to let it go, yeah.
I don't know. I'm not okay
you
with
know,
this.
You know, sometimes, I don't know about you and your bodily functions, but
yeah,
sometimes uh-huh. if I'm taking a piss yeah. and, like, I've got some gas, like, it's yeah. it's hard to hold the gas in and let the piss out. You know?
All right, so you're saying, but then again, you're probably of the belief, as I think you are, knowing you. Now, you can correct me if I'm wrong here. You probably are okay with farting in front of your wife then, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, okay. I 2 marriages, right? First marriage, second marriage, 2 marriages. First marriage, I won't mention the number of years because you'll bleep it out. Second marriage, a lot shorter because it just got married last year or a year and a half ago. Okay, and all of those years... never once farted in front of my wife.
Yeah, see, that's ridiculous to me. That's just like, come on, that's just... At some point, you got to be comfortable doing that. Mar chimed in with, hey, do you guys talk? Did he say, excuse me? Now, Mar, at least for me, man code? Like, if I am with somebody I know...
No, there's no fucking excuse.
No. If I'm with somebody I know, if I'm with my wife, if I am hanging out with friends, I would say, excuse me. But... like in a bathroom with a bunch of other guys that I don't know, I wouldn't. Because nobody gives a shit.
Not
like Doug. If you poll any guy, if you poll men who have been married at least a year,
yeah.
and you ask them, have you ever farted in front of your spouse? I guarantee you the percentage would be quite high.
Yeah. Quite yes. high. That yes. The
in other words, you are the exception, not the rule.
No, I get it. I think that goes back to another conversation we had. Maybe it's part of the whole gas situation. My burper's broken. We already talked about that. Exposition.
You said gas situation. I thought you were talking about like the Holocaust and Sean Spicer again. I'm like, man,
no,
let's not go back there again.
No, I don't want to go to the sarin gas and chemical weaponry. And no, I'm not gonna do that. By the way, it was actually this was a gas chamber that the Jews were sent to. Okay, Spicer, fucking idiot. God damn. Okay. Yeah. So for me, it's hard to hop from one topic to the other.
So anyway, so what's the point? You're mad. You're.
No, I'm just trying to understand. So I'm in the bathroom.
Oh, what's the proper etiquette?
Yeah, I'm in the bathroom at Victoria's, and this guy just lets one go. I mean, huge. I mean, it was gone. It had a tail on it. It was that long a fart. Okay. It was a long wind, and I'm thinking, fuck, dude, just. you had to at some point say, you know, I'm farting a little longer than I probably is appropriate in a public situation. The guy just didn't fucking care. I don't know. Okay. It just rattled my cage a little bit. I'm like, dude, just fucking get out of here. Just go.
You know, Dennis Leary's got a funny gag about that where he's on a plane, right? And they're getting ready to take off and he's got his headphones on, right? And he's like, he's feeling like he's got a little gas and he's like, oh, okay, you know what? I'm just going to like do a little silent, you know, let it slip out a little bit, right?
Right.
And so he's like, oh man, and it's like it's going long and it's like, and he realizes, oh shit, I've got my headphones on. And he pulls his headphones off and he realizes it's like this. And like everybody on the plane is staring at him. He's like, oh, oops, shit, I got to spend the next 5 hours on a plane with these people now.
Yeah, yeah. That's the way I felt about it. And when the guy left the bathroom, I could see he was the chef. And that really bothered me a lot. No, I'm kidding. It wasn't the chef of the restaurant. It was just this guy that I thought personally was rude. All right. So let me ask other questions about bathroom etiquette. Or not etiquette, just bathroom habits. When you're in a public restroom that has the choice between the electric hand dryers, like the Dyson, the ones that really blow hard.
Right.
And a paper towel, what do you use?
Paper towel.
Really? You don't like the Dysons?
Yeah, the electric ones just don't dry your hands that well. Yes, I know it's better for the environment and all other crap, but I'm sorry, they just don't.
Oh, so you don't not use them because of any concerns over like the spreading of the germs in the bathroom or anything like that, do you?
No, I hadn't thought about that.
No, well, that's why my wife, I think, does not like to use the hand dryers that are in the bathroom, because she's like, you're blowing all the germs around. Like, you're really worried about that?
No, but it's after you've washed your hands, so you should have killed all the germs already. You're not wiping germs off, like, after you wash your hands, you're not wiping germs off onto the towel. You're just drying your hand. The germs should be gone already, technically.
I'm okay with this. Okay, so let's move on beyond the hand dryer. So I'm okay with the hand dryers. You're okay with the hand dryers, too. You probably would go more for the paper towels because you feel like they do a more efficient job of actually drying your hands. Okay. Door handle. That's the next thing I need to talk about.
Yeah.
Door handle, do you grab the door handle or do you use a paper towel to grab the door handle?
No,
you pull your sleeve and use your sleeve to do the door handle.
I'm just not that germophobic a guy. I totally understand the argument of, hey, there are lots of people that don't wash their hands and so there's going to be lots of germs on the doorknob. You know what? I am firmly in the camp of there are fucking germs everywhere. And you know what? I haven't died yet.
No, I get it.
Yeah.
I get it. The thing that really hurts, though, in my brain as my thought process goes on is the guy that opened up the door that didn't wash his hands. So that means his junk is on his hands. He opens the door. Now it's on the door handle. The door handle, I'm about to now open. Hey, I'm going to go have my meal. Hey, it's a sandwich. I'm like, then I'm putting his fucking cock in my mouth and I don't want his dick in my mouth.
Well, that would be the argument. Yes.
Okay, so for me, I don't even want to have to think about it. So I'm not saying that germs, it's the visual, it's the whole visual thing. I'm like, I really translate that into that. This equates to that.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody opening up the door with their hand that hasn't washed their hands puts his dick in my mouth, and I am not interested in that. Period. The end. Okay?
And you know what? I am a more practical guy.
What does your
brain
say?
And when I say to him, okay, here's the practical sense, right?
Okay, all right.
So let's say the bathroom has just been washed, and the guy in front of me, he's got his dick in his hand, and he doesn't wash his hands, and I go right behind him. So now those germs are on my hand, and the next thing I do is eat a sandwich, right?
Right, okay.
What is the worst thing that really happens? Whatever germs were on his dick are now in my... You know what? I've probably done it hundreds and hundreds of times before without even realizing it, and I haven't died yet.
I know. Your brain works its way into the understanding that it's not the same as having
him. Exactly.
Can't even say it again.
Rule number one, don't sweat the little stuff. Rule number two, it's all little stuff.
I know. It's so true. It's so true. But that's just one. I can't get the visual. There's so many things I let go. You know, there's so many things I let go in my life like that. That's just one.
Like what? Just give me one that you do let go, because I don't think there really are. that many that you know you let go?
I don't know. I can't give me a scenario, and I will tell you if I'd be able to let go of it.
Doug is now thinking about things that he would let go. Mm. Okay, Doug.
Okay,
Doug, let's go of blank.
I actually don't, nothing is coming to mind. Can
exactly.
you give me a scenario?
No, you see, I'm not trying to be bad, not trying to like be rude, but like you said, oh, there are lots of things I let go of. No, there aren't.
All right. I'll give you one.
Okay.
I'm at the gas tank at the gas station. I've filled mm-hmm. up my tank. Of course, nobody is washing their hands immediately after or before they go to the gas station. They've probably been fucking picking their nose while they're driving, or, you know, maybe who knows what they're doing in their mm-hmm. car? I don't even mm-hmm. want to know what they're doing in their car. Mm-hmm. They fill up the gas station by grabbing the gas handle. They put it away. I'm the next one up. And you know what? There's a Subway in the gas station too. And I have to eat lunch.
Okay.
So I probably got the Subway sandwich as my tank was being filled up. I know I'm not supposed to leave my gas being unattended as it's filling, but I did because I'm trying to preserve some time. That's why I'm at the Subway eating at the Subway.
Yeah, because nobody's going to actually make the choice to go to Subway.
At the gas station.
That's for goddamn sure.
At the gas station, maybe not. I'm sitting back in my car. I turn off the gas because it's filled. I put it, and I don't wash my hands or use the sanitizer or anything. I just eat my sandwich. Same exact situation. They've been picking their nose, and now I'm eating it.
Yeah, but now what's interesting with that is I would think that there's a good chance you might just get a little gas splashed on your hand, and then your hand's going to smell like gasoline because it's such a pervasive smell.
No, I very rare. Do you actually ever spill the gas?
Never, because I don't have to put gas in my car anymore.
That's true.
That's
right. Man, I walked right into that.
You did. You walked right into that one.
I didn't even remember that. Yeah, so that one, I have to let go. I got to let that one go.
That's a good one. Okay, so you do let things go. It's all good then.
I do. Anyway.
We are 37 minutes into the episode, so we probably should wrap it up.
All right. We did everything that we came here to do.
I think so.
Today, I think so.
We want to thank Mar for being a guest for about 12 seconds, where she chimed in twice with three words. We love
Mar.
Having her here. We just wish she would talk more.
Hey, Mar, open up your mic again for a second. I have a question for you.
Okay.
Hey, Mar, what's the woman code for bathroom etiquette?
Oh, you're supposed to wash your hands for sure.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't like when I see people not wash their hands, that's for sure. It's kind of gross.
Would you ever say anything to them?
Sometimes I've said, that's gross.
Oh my gosh, Mar.
Hey there, girl.
You're even further beyond where I would go. I don't have the nerve to say something.
No,
I'm afraid
no.
some dude is going to punch me in the face.
No, I'm like,
girls,
really? Really?
I think you should politely go up to them and go, excuse me, ma'am, you know, I don't know if you're aware of this, but really, after you leave the bathroom, you really should wash your hands, you skanky bitch.
Oh my gosh, I saw somebody from Rubio's, one of the people that work in the kitchen, she was using the bathroom and she didn't wash her hands. And I was like, oh my God, I'm going to tell the manager, this is so gross. Because, you know, they have the signs that say employees must wash their hands, and she totally didn't.
Hold up. You actually saw somebody that works at the restaurant walk out of a bed? No, that is totally not acceptable.
I was like, so grossed out.
Oh, yeah, that's a bad one. Yep, you do not want to laugh.
Yeah.
No, God, I don't want that. That's horrible. Oh, I don't ever want to eat out again. Never want to go out to a restaurant. Never want to do that. You want to name the restaurants? Amar, no, don't do that.
Yeah, I did. It was Rubio's. I was like, oh, my God.
Oh, what's Rubio's? What's Rubio's? We don't have Rubio's here.
It's a fresh Mex grill.
Well, yeah, it's... that explains it.
Fresh Mex. Like, not Tex-Mex.
What the hell is
like
Fresh Mex?
Is that like a Chipotle?
My wife and I went out for Mexican food last night. It was crazy good. Oh, man, I love
Where'd
Mexican
you eat?
Food. There's a place, it's called Villa Maya or Maya Villa, something like that, that's close to our house. It's just a one-off restaurant. And their service is great, and they do the guacamole table side. That's so good. I love Mexican food.
Love Mexican. You know, we could get Mexican food when we go to Gen Blue, October 17th through the 19th in Las Vegas. Mar will be there, right?
Mar, any shot? Are you coming out to Las Vegas in October with us?
I don't know, but I will try.
That's okay.
I can't
there
promise.
Is no try. There is only
I know,
do or do not.
I know. Don't Yoda me.
Don't you? Don't Yoda me. That's great. I wonder if Prosh would go. Do you think he would go? Would he be into it?
He goes all the time.
Hey, yeah, but not with us.
Mar, who do you think is a bigger fan of the show?
True.
You or Prosh?
Me.
Of course. Don't yeah. be silly. Of course.
I hear from some conversations that I've had with Prosh. Prosh and you, whenever you do stuff together, we are the topic of most of your conversation. Is that still true?
Yeah, no. That's what I'm saying. I'm the one that told him about you. Hello.
Oh, we are very flattered that you guys are talking about us.
Yeah, we got to figure out a way to get Mar to Las Vegas. Hopefully she gets this big cushy job and she'll be like an exec and she'll have like oodles of money and she doesn't even matter. Like she could travel and go everywhere and do anything that she wants to do.
Yeah, we're going to get her. If she can't get the day off, we're going to have her call in sick. Hey, Doug, if there was any way possible to get Mar out of work the next day, would she want to stay?
Let me think about that for a second. Any way possible?
Yeah, so that's like a total inside joke that
inside as it gets. Yeah. Nobody other than you and me, nobody even gets that joke.
I know. Sorry, Mar, we can't tell you about it. We'll tell you about it another time.
I mean, we could tell you, but we'd have to kill you.
Kill me?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, Mar has made some connections. She's got this guy from Sumo App. Is that what it's called?
AppSumo.
AppSumo. Now, is that the same one that's like on my all of the pop-ups that are on my website?
And he invented coffee gum.
Yeah.
And plays fiddle.
So AppSumo, that's the thing that I have that has like a gazillion subscribers to it. That's this guy that's going to come on the show. The same guy?
I think so.
That's incredible. And he also invented coffee gum?
Well, he did that as a side project, just for fun.
Yeah.
Just for fun.
Yeah.
Oh, but he said if anyone wants to run his gum business, hit him up because he'll run with it. He just doesn't want to run it, but he invented it. He's like, let's do it. I like gum. I like coffee. I want coffee gum. So he asked this girl to concoct this gum for him, and she did. And he's like, yeah, but I don't want to run the business.
Strick, this is what happens when you have a gazillion dollars in the bank. It doesn't matter. Hey, Strick, I'm trying to come up with a way that would automatically send 100,000 volts through somebody that tries to walk out of the bathroom without washing their hands. Yeah, we have this great invention. It's called the defibrillator. Right?
You get tased.
Oh, God.
That would be great. Hey, Mar, maybe you can come up with an invention while you're in your cave thinking about the other things that we've asked you to do.
Okay. You just send me the assignments. I'll do it.
The number one thing that we need is just a promise statement. That's what we want you to work on.
I think
on.
It sounds good coming out of your mouth. It's fine. I think people understand it.
Strickland?
Hey, it's okay with me. I just wanted to give Mar an opportunity to mold the show if she wanted to. But if you don't want to, then it's okay.
Okay. All right. Well, now that we're 45 minutes into this episode, maybe we should dump out.
Yeah,
now.
Mar,
what
do you
think?
Want to do our outro?
Okay, Steve O'Brien, take us out of here.
Nice Guy Community, what do you think of the Nice Guys podcast? Is it A, interesting, informative, intelligent business information that's really helpful? B, a couple of guys who think they're funny, but actually have an inflated perception of their own self-worth? C, same shit, different podcast? Or D, all of the above? Go with D.
Hey, way to go. Look, we didn't even have to prompt you. That was really good.
That was pretty good. That was good. I was thinking that she might ask.
I was thinking the same thing. But and then I want to go, Mar, you've listened to enough episodes. You know what we say to get out of here. That's good.
I was like, I think so.